guys, it's Aoife from Words of Clover, and I'm here today to talk about a few books that I want to try and read this summer. So this is a little bit of a summer reading TBR. I hope to have these books read by maybe the end of August or September, but I'm definitely kind of going to try and aim to read these over the next few months while the weather is hopefully hot. We can like laze out in the garden and just enjoy some really great reads, hopefully. So the first book I want to read is The Women of Troy by Pat Barker. Now, I've read The Silence of the Girls by Pat Barker, and this is kind of a sequel to that. We are following the same character that we followed in The Silence of the Girls, which is Briseis, and now we are following what happened after Troy, after the siege of Troy. You know, the victors are now in the city, and I think in a similar like vein to The Silence of the Girls, we are now like seeing what is happening through the eyes of the women. And in this now, I think Briseis, you know, she was originally kind of a slave of Achilles, and she was used by him, and she was sexually assaulted by him, and now I believe she's married to someone else, but she's carrying the child of Achilles, and she's having to deal with that while also just seeing her city being destroyed and seeing what is happening to the remains of her city. And I think there's something in this book around the gods are angry, and the victors are kind of being punished a little bit by the gods for not doing certain things. And yeah, I think there's going to be a lot of really interesting, I guess, mythology in this book around what is happening. And then we're also going to get a really interesting like female voice telling the story as well, which I always really enjoy. I love reading books set around the story of Troy, and I really did enjoy Pat Barker's previous book, as I said, The Silence of the Girls. So I'm really looking forward to getting back into her writing and seeing how she continues the story. The next book I want to read is also a historical fiction, and it is set in a time where I have actually read quite a few books about this time in English history, and that is the War of the Roses, or the Cousins' War, so the Tudors versus the Lancasters. And I've actually previously talked about some books that I've read set in this era recently, where I haven't enjoyed them as much as I thought I would, because I kind of felt like I was reading the same story, because obviously if you're reading around the same period in history, you are going to be reading the same stories like over and over, and I was feeling a little bit jaded. But this book, Cecily by Annie Garthwaite, sounds really interesting. So this book follows the life of Cecily Neville, who was the mother of Richard III and Edward the fourth, one of the Edward that reigned before Richard III. I've previously seen Cecily in the White Queen trilogy that was written by Philippa Gregory, and she's not necessarily the nicest character in those books, so I'm really interested in seeing her story and seeing a little bit like before the major battle where Edward became king and then Richard after him, and the War of the Roses like continued kind of in like almost like a second wave of it, where we're going to be seeing kind of the first wave of it with Cecily, and when the boys are younger and she marries Duke York, who could have been king. So yeah, I'm really interested in seeing that, and I think it's going to be a unique voice that I haven't read yet in this time period, as I said. So definitely looking forward to seeing if this one is as good as I think it's going to be. And also has like a really gorgeous cover that definitely suits like summertime. The next book I want to read is one I have on NetGalley, and this is one that I have a feeling is going to be a very addictive read, because the blurb of it is just so intriguing. I don't really need to know too much more than what the blurb is saying to me to know that this is a book I want to read, and it could be one that I get completely sucked into, and if it's a lovely day out in the garden, it might be one where I am reading all day long and until this book is finished. That is what I'm hoping for this. So I'm actually going to read out the blurb to you about this one, because this is one that like just really really intrigued me from the first time I read the blurb, and that is The Long Long Afternoon by Inga Vesper. So it's the summer of 1959, and the well-trimmed lawns of Sunny Lakes wilt under the California sun. At some point during the long, long afternoon, Joyce Haney, a seemingly happy housewife and mother, vanishes from her home, leaving only behind two terrified young children and a blood stain on the kitchen floor. With the stifling heat of Tangerine and the gripping pace of Little Deaths, The Long, Long Afternoon is at once a page-turning mystery and an intoxicating vision of the ways in which women everywhere are diminished, silenced, and ultimately underestimated. So yeah, that sounds really, really good to me. I have not read Tangerine, but I have read Little Deaths. I think it's by Emma Flint that this is compared to, and I did quite enjoy Little Deaths, and I kind of liked the look on motherhood and the gaze on like what a woman should be, how women should act, and particularly around this time period, the 50s, 60s. So yeah, I feel like this is going to be a really interesting read. So the next book I want to read is one that I have on my Kindle, and it's one I bought quite a while ago. I think it was Always Doing who originally was reviewing this book and made me want to pick it up. And that's 40 Love by Olivia Dade. Now Olivia Dade has become known more recently because she wrote Spoiler Alert, which a lot of people have really, really enjoyed. I haven't actually read that one yet, though I did get it from my friend for Christmas. But this is one I have on my Kindle, and it's definitely one that gives me summery vibes, as you can see from the cover. And this is the second book in There's Something About Marysburg series that Olivia writes, but I actually haven't read the rest of the series. But I do believe you can like go in and out of them as standalones, because I think they follow different characters just set in the same town. So this is going to be quite an intriguing kind of like romance, like contemporary book, and there's a lot of elements in this one that I think is going to be really, really fun. Number one, I think Olivia Dade, I think all of her characters tend to be plus size, all the female characters, and her name is Tess, and she ends up in a relationship with this, I think, like a tennis instructor or someone she plays tennis with, and he's actually much younger than her. So she is 40 and he is 26, and I think that is just going to be a really interesting element of the relationship to follow, because I feel like, number one, we don't see enough plus size stories at the moment. I think we're definitely seeing more of them, but we're still not seeing enough where the main character is plus size and proud of it. And then we also don't see a lot of relationships where the woman is older than the man. We'd see loads of times where the man is older than the woman, especially, and same with like just in TV shows and movies, we very rarely see a woman older than a man. It still tends to be quite taboo to have a woman older. So I'm just very interested to see how this book deals with that and how the romance plays out. And I've heard good things about this, and I can't wait to pick it up. And then the last book I'm going to put on this reading list is The Final Revival of Opal and Nev by Donny Walton. I actually don't know if that's supposed to be Nev or Neve. This has been compared to Daisy Jones and the Six, because we are following the formation of this like rock duo in the 1970s, and we're seeing kind of the rise and fall of this two-man band. I think we're also following them decades later when they come together for a reunion, and kind of secrets from all those years ago kind of come out, and there's still a lot of tension between the two of them, and yeah, there's a lot of like things going on. I think this one's gonna be really, really fun to read. I definitely would love to read more books that are in a similar vein to Daisy Jones and the Six, because I did really, really enjoy that one. So I really want to try this and see. This is definitely one I've seen compared to it and being just as good as Daisy Jones and the Six, if not better. And I also think, as far as I know, I believe that at least one of the characters in this is African-American, so I think there are elements of race that are played in this book as well, around the time period and within the music industry as well. So I'm interested to see how that like is in it. Is it a major storyline in it, or is it something kind of just more on the side, just kind of something that's explored a little bit? So yeah, I'm really interested to see this and see what happens in the book. Those are the books I hope to read during this summer. If you guys have read any of these books, or if you want to read them as well, I would love to know what books are on your summer reading list. What books do you really want to get read during this summer? I'd also love to know where people are in the world. Are you in a sunnier climate or in a milder climate? It's just always fun to know where people are, and are you guys hoping for a hot summer or a cool one? So thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you guys again next time. Bye.